I'm truly delighted to be here today. It was 34 years ago that I was here in this beautiful Greek theater, graduating with my MS in EECS. Dean Sastry, distinguished faculty, graduates, parents, families, and friends. As a proud Cal alum, today I congratulate this class of 2014, which I consider is absolutely from the best engineering school in the whole wide world. You have worked hard to achieve this impressive milestone, and I would like everybody to join in giving you a big round of applause once more. Let me start here, a smartphone. Today, an everyday device. 10 years ago, uncommon. 34 years ago, when I graduated from here, unheard of. Step back for a moment. This smartphone has 1,000 times more computing power than that computers, all the computers combined, that put Neil Armstrong on the moon. This SanDisk micro SD 128 gigabyte card, the world's first and only 128 gigabyte card. This is thumbnail sized, and some of you probably can't even see it. It's only 1 millimeter thin. It's used with smartphones to store hours of video and thousands of pictures and songs. This actually also has 1,000 times more storage than all those computers combined that put the man on the moon. So, that moon landing, this smartphone, and this memory card came from the minds of men and women just like you. So my question to you, or even challenge to you, is where will you take us? And what inventiveness will be your legacy? In relation to my journey, I want to start by talking about tenacity. How did I get here? There was no more tenacious person than my father. I was born and raised in India, came to Cal as a junior transfer student in EECS in the fall of 1976. I was thrilled to be here, but my arrival was far from certain. In fact, my application for student visa was denied no less than 3 times. So my father took matters into his own hand, assuming on my behalf the all-in-one roles of chief spokesperson, manager, private detective, and a trial lawyer. Making me tag along with him, he tracked down the US Embassy official in charge of visas returning from lunch one day. Ignoring the man's protests and following him as he headed for his office, my father began his closing argument, so to speak. The official had insisted that there was no way I was going to get my student visa. Yet, my father talked his way into the man's office and convinced him to approve my student visa. I witnessed this performance firsthand myself and have never forgotten it. My dad's tenacious conviction, tenacity, and boldness and courage, not only on that day in the embassy, but throughout his life, has become my mantra. Never, ever give up. If you have a dream, if you have a conviction, if you passionately believe in something, then reach deep down within yourself and don't accept no for an answer. So graduates, if you seek success, start with tenacity. My memories of Cal are sweet. My first quarter here, fall of 1976, I was staying at the I House. Some Saturday afternoons, while entrenched in iHouse's library like a typical nerd, I would hear annoyingly loud bursts of crowd noise and cheers coming from outside. What's going on? I wondered. Well, I eventually figured that it was Cal football at Memorial Stadium next door. To cut a long story short, I quickly forgot Saturdays at the library and was soon adding to the noise myself. I was initially clueless about football, but soon became the huge fan that I am now. And on that Saturday of November 20th, 1982, as a proud Cal alum, I even witnessed the Cal versus Stanford game. And yes, the play. That memory of the play still gives me goosebumps. When I watch replays of that unforgettable ending, all the frantic scrambling and constant forward momentum during the play, it really reminds me a lot of business in the tech industry. Football aside, I also do not remember Cal as a cakewalk. I worked hard just like you. I remember learning assembly language in CS41, which I'm now told is CS61C, from Randy Katz. He was my teaching assistant, your faculty marshal today. I remember working long days, nights, getting programs to work at the computer center in Cody Hall. I remember endless lab reports, working in small teams, wrestling with circuit theory, integrated circuit, computer architecture, and the like. I'll also never forget my two friends, the two Charlies, who would have loud technical boxing matches at the blackboard in 373 Cory Hall, where we shared office. Charlie Sudini is now a celebrated MIT professor. Charlie Giancarlo was number two at Cisco and is now an entrepreneur par excellence. So my advice to you is keep your network of Cal friends tight-knit. You can change the world together. Beyond hard work, from my first day at Intel Corporation to 34 years later as president and CEO of SanDisk, I have incorporated the engineer's analytical, methodical, and logical approach to tackling problems, whether managerial or technical in nature. Trust me, graduates, you are leaving Cal with the best problem-solving skills and knowing the value of teamwork and hard work. Be assured, your education here will shape your future in more powerful ways than what you can imagine today. Your journey will most likely be completely different from mine. In fact, you may be sitting there right now, trying to imagine the milestones and outcomes of your journey. Like you, I had a vivid imagination of what the world might offer me. But my imagined world was quite different from my real world. My real world offered me SanDisk Corporation. SanDisk started 26 years ago in 1988, before the internet, before digital cameras, mobile phones, and laptop computers. Three engineers, Dr. Eli Harari, a device physicist, Jack Yuan, a process technologist, and I, a design engineer, started SanDisk. Also, three immigrants, one from Israel, one from China, and one from India. Certainly, the risk of our startup made me a bit nervous at the beginning, but I had the loving, ongoing support of my wife, Sangeeta, as she awaited the birth of our first daughter, Mansi. Both are here today, along with our lovely younger daughter, Malika. Our vision for SanDisk was that there would be a growing need for a new semiconductor memory type coined as flash storage. We imagined just how to make such flash memory. We imagined digital cameras, computers, fax machines, copiers, and so on that would need such flash storage. Some of you, I bet, right now are taking selfies using flash on your phone and posting them on Instagram. And my daughters told me that I need to do the same here as well. And I can tell you, we never imagined that application of flash when SanDisk started 26 years ago. The rest is history for us. And let me just give you one more example here. Let me tell you that all the future company founders that are here, the early days at SanDisk were not easy. It took many years for our technology to be accepted by the marketplace. At one point, Kodak even wanted us to be an exclusive supplier to them. For a startup that had hardly any sales at that time, this was gut-wrenching. We could have accepted Kodak's offer of millions of dollars, but we had grander vision. We passed on that, instead choosing to work with the broader world of digital camera companies and making our media an open industry standard. The rest is history for us, and Kodak, as we knew it then, is also history. I have to give the credit for declining that Kodak offer to Eli Harari, who was the then CEO. He had the passion, conviction, tenacity to stay focused on what we originally imagined. That was quite some bet, in my opinion. From a 1988 startup to now, SanDisk has grown to a publicly traded global provenance with over $6 billion in revenue. So graduates, trust your imagination as you navigate through the real world. Now I promised myself that my words to you today would not be just platitudes, or as my daughters would say, chicken soup for your CPU. I have talked very briefly about my journey. You are about to take a similar journey of your own. Like a good mentor, let me give you a few GPS coordinates. First, innovation alone is not enough. Making innovation meaningful requires execution, tenacity, attention to detail, and trusting your imagination, even in the most difficult of the moments. The believer and the builder are co-captains on the same team. If you can imagine a better mousetrap, doesn't mean that you can necessarily build one. It really takes SanDisk more than 5,000 people today to make the company successful. So the believer and the builder really need to work together to make something originally imagined become a success. Second, no guts almost means no glory. Take risks, be adventurous. Don't wait for all the answers. Get started. Get started now, but don't be reckless. Find a smarter and responsible way to do it faster, better, and cheaper. I'm not a gambling man, but believe me, your quest will be more exciting if you place some bets and win. You lose a few times too, and that's all right. Third, find your mentors, the ones that can change your life. Your heart will tell you who they are. Be on the lookout for them, and when you find them, don't let them go easily. I was fortunate enough to have had three mentors. My father, he put me on the path to higher education and taught me the basic values in life. George Perlegos, my first boss at Intel, he taught me how to design chips and how to take responsibility for their production success. Eli Harari, whom I first met at Intel Corporation, and who later facilitated my transformation from an engineer to a business leader. I can't imagine what my life would be like without the influence of these three mentors. They shaped my skills, my career, and my life. Aside from picking the right industry, the right company, the right job, and the right team, I want you to be constantly on the lookout for movers and shakers, the high achievers who can mentor you. In the best sense of the phrase, take advantage of them. Great mentors can accelerate your career growth, help you learn faster, do more, and they make you shine. 34 years ago, I sat where you are sitting today, even though I couldn't possibly imagine then what 2014 would really be like, let me now challenge you to imagine 34 years from now. Imagine 2048. for the geeks in us, that happens to be the year 800 in hex, a nice round number. Well, will life be like Star Trek, with tricorders to instantly diagnose our ailments? Will we be teleporting across the solar system or beyond? Of course, no one knows. However, what I do know is that you, as Cal graduates, will be pioneering and shaping the world on your journey. So congratulations, graduates. Go make this world even more beautiful and astounding. Work hard, be tenacious, find that life-changing mentor. Remember, no guts, no glory. Trust your imagination. You are the future. Go and amaze us. And one more thing, go Bears! Thank you.